Hello and welcome to the Montage Film Review Sunday DVD Rental Suggestion Podcast, the objective of which is to help you sort the wheat from the chaff. Today I would like to bring you White Noise from 2005, directed by Geoffrey Sax and starring Beetlejuice himself, Michael Keaton. Keaton plays architect Jonathan Rivers, who loses his second wife Anna in what he and the police both believe is an accident. However, as a result of Rivers being contacted by Raymond Price, played by Ian McNeice, who dabbles in EVP, electronic voice phenomena, he embarks on a journey to discover what really did happen to his wife. In short, was she killed in an accident or was she murdered? And was the perpetrator of this world or the next? Now, initially, Rivers is not convinced by this whole EVP malarkey, but he then begins using it himself and trying to help other people with it, or at least so he thinks. But what he doesn't realise is it's never as straightforward as that. And you can use EVP as much as you like, but you're never in the know really about whether or not you're dealing with the dark side or not. Now, this movie is much better than the overly hyped Paranormal Activity, which I regret to say spawned a sequel. It's an interesting movie with great production values, and although I didn't find it scary myself, I don't really think that the objective was to terrify the audience. You would really enjoy this if you liked such films as the recent Knowing from 2009 with Nicolas Cage, Stir of Echoes starring Kevin Bacon, or the Final Destination movies. The actors give good performances, and it's really nice to see Michael Keaton again. Now, this film did spawn a sequel of its own, but it's not as good as this one. And as the narratives are not connected in the two movies, you can watch one without watching the other. So my advice to you is watch this one. This movie is the last movie in our month of movies about religion. I've chosen this movie because of its theme of life after death, which is a prominent feature in any religion, in any part of the globe. But in order to convey to you exactly why this title is on the list, I'm going to have to get a little bit hardcore with you, which should really excite all of those uber film geeks out there. Now, the title of this movie is representative of the television static that is used as a conduit for the dead to talk to the living. People who actually use EVP use old tape recorders specifically because static is a constant background noise on the tape. Water is also considered to be a conduit between dimensions. And in this film, water is used a lot as part of its canvas. You will notice the countless waterfalls included in the architecture of the buildings that make up the locations of the film. Some of them running at a trickle to mirror the pinpoints of light on the many TV screens used by the protagonist in contacting the recently departed. This is what is called effective mise-en-scène and sends subliminal messages to the audience. The same effects result from the use of windows in the film. Windows are everywhere, along with images of water, windows, water and television screens, all helping to reinforce the basic storyline of the movie, which is that if Einstein is right, there are other universes or dimensions all around us, and with a slight change of frequency, we could communicate with the people that dwell in them. And there are portals, wormholes, all around that the average person is completely oblivious to. Not bad, huh? Techniques such as these are why white noise is an above average B-movie of sorts. I hope you've enjoyed this month of movies about religion. I've chosen movies that would appeal mostly to people who are turned off by conventional religion. And I've chosen the month of December because it's a festive month, the most festive month of the year. This is the last podcast for 2010. I will see you in 2011. I have lots of wonderful movies lined up for you for January. We will be going to America, to France, to Japan, and back to America again. I'm your host, Shay Trinity, and as always, this is the Montage Film Review Sunday DVD Rental Suggestion Podcast, an Eskimo Fin production.